this point, I've been talking about writing and emailing, but of course, it's always important to show people your work. Number one, photography and good quality photography is extremely critical. If you don't document a project from the beginning, you'll never get back there and document it. So you want to make sure that you take good photography and really have a good record of what you did. I mean, you don't have to do it for every project, but for your major projects where you want to do a major press campaign, you really need to have good quality photography. And then, second, if you have a project where the process of construction was very difficult, or maybe there was a big design challenge, it's really important to gather that information so that you can demonstrate the benefits that you brought to the project to talk about the complexity in the work that you did. For example, if your firm is an engineering firm and the architect sends out a photographer, that photography is probably not going to be able to to cover your story. And you really want to be able to tell your story. So make sure that you have either graphics or photography that really talks about your particular story that you can send to an editor. I mean, there's nothing more frustrating for an editor to get a great story but then have no visuals, for you to describe that. And so, as I mentioned before, there are just so many stories you can tell about a particular project, but there are a wide range of tools that you can use to promote your services. And now, as we all know, with social media and online publications, you just have so many more channels than you ever did before. I mean, when I started out in this industry, we had print, right? And think about it now. There are just so many ways you can talk about your work. It's really incredible. So these are all to your advantage, and you should really use them. So for example, you can send out an announcement to highlight some firm news or information. Send out some information about a new project. You can pitch articles to the press. So articles, by that I mean you could do a feature story on a particular project. You could do a trend story that encapsulates a number of different projects in one trend. Or you could do a byline article, which is a story that someone in your firm writes and then they get their name at the end, which is the byline. And that's really important if you want to demonstrate thought leadership. You can invite an editor to your office, or you can go to the editor's office for what we call an editorial briefing and show them your recent work. You can start a blog, and blogs are great for a number of reasons. One, they can demonstrate your expertise, and then they can add to your SEO. Consider this statistic, that 67% more B2B companies with blogs generate more leads than companies that don't have blogs. So that's two-thirds. So they can really boost your marketing efforts. And then, of course, you can do video, and you can pay to do a professional video, but you don't necessarily have to do professional video. You can do a video of your project with an iPhone, really, because architecture and construction are the kind of professions where it's very hard to capture everything in a still image. So we're lucky that we have video today to really be able to tell stories better. Now, if you have a really newsworthy project that's accessible, we think that you should really make those connections with people in person, with an editor. So you could have a one-on-one tour of a project. If you have a project you think that there's a particular writer might like, or if you have a really big project or a really prestigious project, You can organize a media tour of that project. Of course, that will take more time, but it can really pay off if you have the right project and you can organize a tour of, maybe arrange transportation on a bus, or if it's local, people can just get there on their own. But media tours can be really effective, and there's really, even in this day and age of so many digital communications, there's just really no substitute for having people see the project in person. This was interesting because we did a media tour of the Kahn Bathhouse, which is a Louis Kahn project in New Jersey, and we got some really nice press for it. But what's funny about it is one of the people who was on the tour actually did a story about all of us coming down on the bus to Trenton, New Jersey. So we also got some other nice articles, but we were actually amused by this, that we became the subject of the article. And then, of course, social media, and you definitely want to use it. You know, we see social media as just another series of channels to get your word out. You still need to be very mindful of your messages and the content that you put out on social media, but it just offers you more opportunities to get out in front of people. I mean, you're in the business of communications. It's that simple. Social media is just more ways for you to communicate. So it shouldn't really replace anything that you're already doing, but it can really add to what you're doing. And you all know, you know, that there are so many different kind of networks. You know, obviously Facebook and Twitter, Pinterest and Instagram, which are great for our industry because you can, you know, because they're visually based platforms, LinkedIn and YouTube. There are multiple channels. So the most important thing with social media is to pick a few that work. Make sure that they're the kinds of channels you think that your potential audiences would be using, and try to master a couple of channels. Don't try to throw a big blanket over all social media and try it all at once, because you're not going to be successful at it. But it's really important for really any for any PR program, any outreach program. I remember when email was started happening. And someone sent me an email, and this person happened to be like three blocks away from me. And I was like, why would you ever send an email when I can just pick up the phone and call you, right? I thought it was so stupid, right? I'm like, why would you send me an email? Of course, now it's many years later, and I've gotten over that. But these are things that are just, have changed the industry, and you really need to embrace them, or you will look behind the times. And then we also think that speaking engagements are really important if you want to demonstrate your expertise. So even if your firm leaders are not speaking directly in front of potential clients, it's really good way to get them in front of potential clients. The other thing is that you can tape a speaking engagement and put it on YouTube. These things have a lot of life to them. Or if you have a script from somebody who spoke at a conference, you can then take that same content and turn it into an article. So they're good for multiple reasons. The other thing is, here you see that this isn't just about, we were talking about press releases and pitching your particular project. What's nice about this is that this is about architecture telling a story. It's about an idea. It's about a theme, which is really engaging. It's like a story about a story. But if you want to do thought leadership and really demonstrate your expertise, or the leaders in your firm do, it's a really great way to expand your presence, and also to go beyond just a specific project and really talk about your ideas and your knowledge. The other thing is that in addition to speaking, we also advocate for getting involved in professional organizations. And those could be organizations, a lot of people join trade organizations where they think their clients might be. So, Cornet or SCUP, for example. And those are really important. But just, any time that you're out of your comfort zone and you're in a group of advisors or experts, it's just a great way to build your network, and you never know, one thing can lead to another. So really, we really advocate for going out and really casting a wide net.